Hello, welcome to my fishing flies in the Blues Man Cave. Today I'm listening to B.B. King, a fantastic guitar player. Okay, over to flies. I've been asked to make a video in English on my fly, the Leatherman. That was a fly I invented a couple of years ago. The purpose of the fly was to imitate everything and nothing, and it does. This year I caught over 75% of all my trouts on that fly, and I've used it in caddis hatches, mayfly hatches, midge hatches, everything, just doing different sizes. And I tie it in hook size 8 to 20, but the main size is 14. I tie it on Arex FWY 500 and 502. That's the hook I'm using. CDC feathers, natural CDC feathers, dense feathers. Can use a little bit 3 to 5 centimeters long, and have to be some dense feathers to get the right proportion on the fly. The body, hurl, and it's smart to use the hurl more in the top, who is a little bit more dense to get the right building of the thorax. The hackle, whitening hen, furnace or greenwells, it's with this one. And the thread, it's Semperfly Nano Silk 18-0. That's the thread I'm using. This fly this year has been very, very interesting to use, because I normally use different flies, 30, 40 flies a year. But as I said, this year, I've used it in every situations. In the lakes, I can place it in the place where the fish are rising, laying it still and twist it a little bit, some centimeters, and the fish turns and takes it. So it's smart to test it. So now we're going to Taiwan. See you soon.
Okay, welcome back. I take my tying thread, Semperfly Nano Silk 18-0. Start in front, and I make a little foundation here. I cut it off. Then I take two CDC feathers. It has to be a couple of pretty dense CDC feathers, and I line them up like this, and I just drag them between my fingers to get the right length, like that. The trick is to get it long enough. I have a mark on my stick, so I get approximately same length every time. It's a little bit training. It's better to make the post longer than too short. Then I fasten it good, and I work myself backwards hard like this, and down into the bend a little bit like that. And I go forward again. I cut off like that. And just tie down a little bit here. And I go back. Then the hurl. It's important to have a hurl. It's a little bit dense, not too thin, so we get a quite big thorax, like that. And I tie it on here. Approximately there. I'm not using a hackle plier. I hope it will work nice. Like this. And one more turn. I stop there. About 2 mil from the head. Like that. And I secure it. Like this. This fly has been fantastic this year. Like that. I get it off. Like that. Then wax. Very important to wax the thread here. Like that. I make a layer here with wax, like that. Then the whitening hen, furnace or greenwells. Like that. Soon. There we are, like this. There. Like that. This is the critical point on the fly tying of this fly, like that. I'll take my heckle plier. And I coast a little bit with the heckle. Like this. One. Two. Three. That's enough. I lock it. 2-3 turns, and get it off down there, like this. Then I fold everything back, and I split them on top, drag the heckle down, like this, and I make some wraps like this, like that. That's nice. Sometimes it's a little bit struggle to get them placed right, like that. There. Yes, that's perfect. Like this, and some wraps in front. Mm-hmm. And it's way more important to have the post long than too short. Then I take my finish. That. Cut it off. Then I take this and cut it off like that. This is the Leatherman. As I said, I've taken 75% of all my trouts this year on this fly in every possible situation. Here, Leatherman, ready for some brown trouts. Thank you for watching. I see you again. Thank you.